House Speaker Paul D. Ryan's abrupt retirement announcement caused a stir on Capitol Hill.
This year will be my last one as a member of the House.
He cited the need to spend more time with his family and was also facing a Democratic challenger with a huge campaign war chest.
I have no regrets whatsoever for having accepted this responsibility.
But what is Ryan's legacy after nearly 20 years in Congress? The Wisconsin representative turned Republican House leader entered the chamber in 1999 as a deficit hawk.
We don't get this deficit and debt under control, it really hurts our economy and job creation.
This debt is getting out of control.
A debt crisis is coming to this country.
He worked for a large part of his congressional career on the House Budget Committee and then the House Ways and Means Committee, pushing without much success to lower taxes and government spending.
Government spending is on a breakneck pace.
Ryan rose in national prominence when Republican presidential candidate Mitt Romney chose him as his vice presidential pick in 2012. And again when the House Freedom Caucus backed his candidacy for Speaker of the House in 2015.
We are wiping the slate clean.
As Speaker, Ryan raised millions for Republican colleagues, pushed a tax cuts bill through Congress, and boosted military spending. But his popularity has plummeted since taking the gavel, while the national debt, one of his priorities, has skyrocketed. He's leaving the legislative branch with annual spending deficits projected to reach $1 trillion by 2020. His 2.5 years as Speaker have been besieged by partisan fighting and infighting, congressional gridlock, and a rocky relationship with President Trump. Ryan has lamented the identity politics that Trump rode into office.
I think identity politics has gotten out of control in this country.
Not prey on people's separations or their identities.
Yet he worked to push the president's agenda through Congress.
I'm grateful for the president to give us this chance to actually get this stuff done.
Ryan's departure comes during a time when civility and bipartisanship are on the decline in today's political climate.